Good evening. This is Papa Alpha Zero Echo Tango Echo with the Daily Minutes.
Nog steeds een iets wat eenvoudige versie van de Daily Minutes, maar gaandeweg gaan we dus weer beginnen. Eén nieuwsbericht in het Nederlands vandaag. De rest van de uitzending is nog even in het Engels. Heatkit heeft weer van zich laten horen met nieuwe bouwpakketten, of in ieder geval één nieuw bouwpakket. En er is een shop, shop.heatkit.com. Verder zit het bedrijf ook op eBay met als account DataPro. Nog even een dienstmededeling over de uitzendingen van de komende dagen. De komende dagen dus nog steeds wat eenvoudiger versies van de gebruikelijke uitzendingen. De lange uitzending op PI3 UTR gaat morgenavond, vrijdag, dus nog niet door. Vrijwel zeker is er de week erop wel weer een uitzending op vrijdagavond. Aan het eind van de uitzending is er heel simpel één woord in morse, zonder verder commentaar.
A coronal mass ejection, or CME, will be the focus of a National Military Auxiliary Radio System, or MARS, communication exercise in early November, and MARS is hoping to collaborate with Ares and RACES groups. The MARS exercise will get underway on November 8th and continue into November 10th. The exercise scenario will simulate a CME event and focus on actions that radio operators should take prior to and following a CME event, explained Army MARS Program Manager Paul English. WD8DBY. One thing we want to continue to work on is the interface with the greater amateur radio community. CMEs are huge explosions of gas, plasma, and electromagnetic radiation from the sun, which are responsible for geomagnetic storms. Solar flares can accompany CMEs, but they are not the same thing. A CME can take anywhere from 1 to 3 days to reach Earth. CMEs occur all the time, but most bypass Earth with minor effects. A major CME that hits Earth directly could damage or destroy satellites as well as terrestrial communication and electrical power infrastructure. During the exercise, we will simulate the blackout with a 3-hour pause, and then we will bring stations back on air and begin handling requests for information, he told ARRL. Training objectives for this exercise will include understanding what a CME is and how much forecast lead time can be expected, the effects associated with a CME, and what precautions radio operators take to protect their equipment prior to a severe CME.
This is Peter John with the DX Headlines. Lima Alpha 7 X-ray Kilo, Lima Alpha 6 Victor Mike, and Lima Alpha 9 Delta Lima will be active from Svalbard Islands October 7 until 12 as Juliet Whiskey 7 X-ray Kilo, Juliet Whiskey 6 Victor Mike, and Juliet Whiskey 9 Delta Lima. They will be operating on HF bands with a focus on 160 meters. Lima Zulu 1, Golf Charlie, Oscar Mike 5, Zulu Whiskey and Kilo Kilo 7 Lima will be active from Tuvalu until October 14 as Tango 2 Golf Charlie. They will be operating on 160 to 6 meters CW single sideband at Riti from Vaiaku Lagi Hotel, Funafuti. Their target for this operation will be 30,000 QSOs. Victor Echo 7 India Golf will be active from Cap Breton Island until October 18 as Victor Echo 1 Delta X-ray Alpha. He will be operating on HF bands. Delta Lima 1 Alpha Sierra will be active from Belize until mid-October 2015 as Victor 31 Delta Lima. He will be operating on 160 to 6 meters. Delta Lima 7 Victor Oscar Golf will be active from Martinique Island November 10 until December 8 as Foxtrot Mike Delta Lima 7 Victor Oscar Golf. He will be operating on HF bands including activity in CQWWDXCW contest as call sign being Tango Oscar 4 Golf Uniform, not being Tango Oscar 4 X-ray as announced before. Golf 4 India Romeo November will be active from Honduras November 21st to 30 as Hotel Romeo 2 Juliet. He will be operating on HF bands including activity in CQWWDXCW contest. Foxtrot 4 Echo Golf X-ray will be active from Kerguelen Islands end of 2015, early 2016 as Foxtrot Tango 4 X-ray Uniform. He will be operating on HF bands and using a Yaesu FT857 transceiver with a dipole. This was Peter John for the DX Headlines on the mighty KBC.
It's Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo.
VK1 WIA.
VK2 and Weissen involved in aircraft search looking for the ill-fated VH MDX Cessna 210 aircraft in the Barrington Tops Wilderness in the Hunter Valley. It continues on the weekend of October 17 and 18 with Weissen New South Wales again taking part. On Sunday the 9th of August 1981, the aircraft disappeared with five people on board. In previous searches, Weissen provided VHF and UHF communications for search teams from a command post and managed and logged all radio communication.
Whoever designed the Lincolnshire Poacher, they certainly have a sense of humour. They've made the voice a British voice. It has different intonation at the end of every single group of five numbers.
4, 7, 5.
And they've picked this folk tune as basically its theme song. It's quirky, it's illogical, it's irrational, and I want to find out who's behind it.
The Swedish Rhapsody was made famous by Mantovani, played on a music box by a very young sounding German female that sent out five-figure groups after the Swedish Rhapsody tune finished.
The girl would say Achtung, and then she would say Gruppe, Neuen, Neuen, and then she would go into the groups, spieling them out until they were finished. The Spanish Lady is another number station, and we can infer that it's a lady, so it's a female voice, and she's speaking in Spanish. It's the station that comes out of Cuba, I think.
The gongs were the most sinister of the number stations. The gongs would literally send a shiver down your spine. They started off as some sort of church gongs, but they seemed to be recorded on an old reel-to-reel tape that stretched over the years. So the amount of wow on the tape made the gong sound really weird. This is an old East German Stasi station that used to come on the air every evening.
I couldn't help wondering if the whole thing might still be one huge radio prank. The audio daubings of some mad pirate DJ. A hoax. Aliens from outer space?
If you buy a shortwave radio and you go and tune it any time of the day or night, you can find number stations. Now, if this were some kind of performance artist, it's first of all somebody who has a lot of money, and he's been doing it for 30 years in a bewildering variety of forms. Secondly, he's got to be one of the biggest radio pirates in the history of radio, because these transmissions are unlicensed, and he's been violating laws all over the world, and I mean, that is not satisfying for anybody who wants a reasonable explanation.
Richard Norton Taylor, who's written about the security services in The Guardian for years, argues that the post-war history of spookdom might lend credibility to the theory that number stations really are secret spy transmissions.
All the evidence is, in past cases during the Second World War and afterwards, the beginning of the Cold War really, in the 40s and early 50s, that a number of spies caught in Britain were found to have shortwave radios on them. Communications were basically used for guidance, for instructions, for warnings, for discussing, you know, movements maybe. It can actually give real intelligence a sense of movements of, say, an enemy troops. Gobbledygook, you don't know what on earth the messages are, but there's a simplicity of it, and everyone can hear it if they want to, but it's destined for one listener, and only one listener can understand it.
This view is generally shared by the former MI5 operative, David Shaler.
Well, if you've got agents in the field, you will want to give those agents instructions.
The curious thing is about it, it's quite secure, isn't it?
Well, this is it. I mean, you've only got to look at Allo Allo, for example, to see the benefit of using a shortwave radio and a code. I mean, obviously, they had the code book in that. And I say, it's absolutely simple. It can be done in many, many different ways. I mean, one of the best and simplest codes to use is if you both have the same edition of a book, for example. And you can then take words out of that book by communicating by what page it's on, what line it's on, what stage it is in the line of the book. And of course, make it even more complicated. It wouldn't be as simple as that. It would be, say, 2 added to the page number, 1 taken away from the line, 6 added to the word number on the line or whatever. And those codes are impossible to break. I mean, despite all this modern technology and so on, these really are the simplest ways to communicate. And they have none of the comeback that we have now. I mean, for example, email traffic, mobile phone traffic, all telephone traffic, you can build up a picture of people's contacts. Even if you don't know what they're saying, is you can build up patterns of activity and so on from those kind of records. Whereas this, of course, has none of that comeback, because nobody's actually receiving a telephone call. All they're doing is putting a radio on and listening to stuff that's out there in the ether.
3, 5, 3, 5.
Papa Alpha 0, Echo Tango Echo.